ओके, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद ओरल एंड मैक्सिलोफेशियल सर्जरी. इंट्रोडक्शन, वी विल टॉक अबाउट डेफिनेशन, हिस्ट्री एंड स्कोप्स ऑफ ओरल एंड मैक्सिलोफेशियल सर्जरी. सो स्टार्टिंग विद द डेफिनेशन विच वॉज गिवन बाय पीटरसन, ओरल एंड मैक्सिलोफेशियल सर्जरी इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ डेंटिस्ट्री दैट इंक्लूड्स डायग्नोसिस एंड सर्जिकल एंड एडजंक्टिव ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ डिजीज, इंजरीज, डिफेक्ट्स including both functional and aesthetic aspects of hard and soft tissues of oral and maxillofacial region. So once again, it's a specialty of dentistry that includes diagnosis and surgical as well as adjunctive treatment of disease, injuries, defects, including both functional and aesthetic aspects of hard and soft tissues of oral and maxillofacial region. Coming to the qualities of surgeon, so a surgeon should be bold and energetic in thought. Action should be sympathy and compassion with surgical skills. He should possess zeal and ardor. Ardor means he should be passionate about the subject. He should be enthusiastic, excited for the surgery. His knowledge should be updated, and he should willing to share the knowledge with colleagues, and should seek the opinions from seniors, also from the colleagues, persons from other medical faculty. Now coming to history of oral and maxillofacial surgery. So it started with earlier time, like 460 BC's Hippocrates. So Hippocrates was a Greek physician who described about the manual reduction, which we do today. It was done earlier in 460 BC's, manual reduction of dislocated TMJ. So Hippocrates' history of oral surgery begins with the 500 BC to 300 BC, and the famous Greek physician Hippocrates described about the manual reducing the dislocation of mandible, right? Uske baad, barbers. So a guild of barbers were created in France that was split in two groups. Some barbers will do the complex operations and some barbers will do the simpler surgical procedures. After that, in 1575, Ambrose Peyer, he is one of the father of surgeries, who told about the tooth extraction, how to manage the jaw fractures, and all the complete works about surgery. Then in 1728, Pierre Fauchard, he is also known as the father of modern dentistry, right? Pierre Fauchard. So he wrote a treatise. Treatise is a long book, right? Treatise is a long book. Which was named as the surgeon dentist. Then we have Simon Houlihan. Now Simon Houlihan was first oral and maxillofacial surgeon in US, right, in Pennsylvania. He was the first oral and maxillofacial surgeon in the US. Coming to leaders of the 20th century, we have Chalmers J. Lyons. He established the principle of gentle surgery that advanced the specialty. He had extensive contribution for the oral surgery literature. Then we have Cryer, Matthew Cryer. Matthew Cryer was the first, he established the first dental service at Philadelphia Hospital. And he also told about many surgical instruments which are used to remove the teeth and other surgical procedures. One such is Cryer elevator. Then we have Robert Ivey. Robert Ivey, if you know about Ivey loops, then he gave the IV loop, which is a method of intermaxillary fixation, treatment of a jaw fractures. So he was also a great founder of oral surgery as well as plastic surgery. During the Second World War, OMFS was emerged as a major specialty. Then we come to the Indian history. In Indian history, father of Indian surgery, Sushruta. Right? Sushruta said that surgery is the first and highest division of healing art. Pure in itself, perpetual in its applicability, a working product of heaven and sure of fame on earth. So this was told by Sushruta in 400 BC, and in 600 BC he taught and practiced surgery on the banks of Ganga. Then contribution by the Sushruta, he gave Sushruta Samhita, 120 surgical instruments. He told about 300 surgical procedures, 650 drugs, and much more. Also, the rhinoplasty, the forehead flap rhinoplasty, and he is considered to be the father of plastic surgery and cosmetic surgery. Now coming to father of oral surgery, James Edmund Gerriston. He was known as the father of oral surgery because he named the specialty as OMFS. He gave treatise, again a long book, on diseases and surgery of mouth, jaws and associated parts that was first published in 1869, and he helped oral maxillofacial surgery as a subspecialty in US, United States. Then we come to the scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery. So we have a vast scope of OMFS, including dentoalveolar surgery, orthognathic surgery, temporomandibular joint surgery, maxillofacial trauma, implantology, cleft lip, cleft palate surgery, craniofacial surgeries, head and neck surgeries, reconstructive surgeries, and facial aesthetic surgeries, and so on. So these are all the basic units which you are going to study in your syllabus, oral and maxillofacial syllabus. So I will give you a synopsis about all the particular topics. So if you see dentoalveolar surgery, in this you will deal about how to remove an impacted teeth, difficult tooth extractions, extractions on a medically compromised patients, bone grafting, as well as pre-prosthetic surgery, how you do the pre-prosthetic surgery, placement of implants, implant-supported CDs. So forceps extraction is basically surgical removal performed on a tooth which is fully erupted and have solid intact crown that can be grasped firmly with the help of a forceps. So that is a forceps extraction. Surgical extraction, also known as open view or transalveolar approach, then you cut the bone and take out the tooth or the root portion. Then we have impacted tooth surgery, so surgical removal of an impacted teeth. Right, impacted teeth, it can be soft tissue impaction or hard tissue impaction. You will read about detail in the impaction unit. So soft tissue impaction means only soft tissue is present over the tooth, and the hard tissue, that is completely bony, embedded. Then we come to the multiple extractions and alveoloplasty. So alveoloplasty is a type of a pre-prosthetic surgeries in which you do smoothening and contouring of the alveolar crest. So how you smoothen it? You use this, if you see the Dean's alveoloplasty, we cut the interdental septa either with the BP blade or either you cut with this Ronger. This is Ronger, bone Ronger, and you cut this. So this is a pre-prosthetic surgery. Then we have alveoloplasty. Alveoloplasty, this is a bone file, right? Bone file is used to rounden and rounden the sharp edges, right? You can rounden it with the help of a bone file, or you can cut it with the help of a bone Ronger. Coming to another scope, orthognathic surgery. So in orthognathic surgery, like in patient with a maxillary prognathism, retrognathism, vertical maxillary excess, vertical maxillary deficiency, mandibular retrognathism, prognathism, so all this covered under the unit of orthognathic surgery. And there you know about maxillary osteotomies, how you cut the maxilla and you perform the surgery, and how you do the mandibular osteotomies. In maxillary, one such osteotomy is Lefort 1 osteotomy, popular osteotomy. Then we have mandible, we have BSS, so bilateral split sagittal osteotomy. And we have genioplasty, you can see the chin here. So you see the chin before, it is mandibular retrognathism and chin is receded. And here you see after genioplasty, a straight profile is there. Okay. Then we have TMJ disorders. So in TMJ, every TMJ disorder, including the muscle disorders, MPDS, derangement disorders, displacement, disc displacement, degenerative disorders, TMJ ankylosis, every disorder of a temporomandibular joint is being treated under this OMFS specialty. Then we have trauma, right? In trauma, we can have Lefort fractures, skull fractures, nasal bone fractures, zygomatic fractures, mandibular fracture, and orbital fracture. And combined, if you see, it is a naso-orbito-ethmoidal fracture, NOE fractures. So all these fractures can be treated by the help of oral and maxillofacial surgery. It is a scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery. Then we come towards the implants. Of course, implants, you can see here the implants. Implant refers to osseointegration between structural, biological, and functional metal implant with healthy bone without soft tissue involvement. Okay, so this is implant, and here in this slide you can see the implant supported CD. Okay, in which you have maxilla. In maxilla you have four implants which are splinted with a bar. So splinted with a bar, four implants, and this implant supported complete denture will settle over these implants. Then we have another scope, congenital craniofacial deformities. Example, cleft lip, cleft palate treatment. Then you have other congenital craniofacial deformities. Examples, you can have Crouchen syndrome, Binder syndrome, tracheoscholian syndrome, your cleidocranial dysostosis, craniofacial dysostosis. Any type of craniofacial deformity can be treated by the oral and maxillofacial surgery. Then we have chronic facial pain disorders. So in chronic facial pain, all the facial pain, right, you know about the Bell's classification of orofacial pain, all the types of orofacial pain, which consists of migraine, tension headache, fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue, burning mouth, atypical odontalgia, myofacial pain, TMDs, temporomandibular joint disorders, and the basic one, which is your Bell's palsy, trigeminal neuralgia, and your MPDs. So these three, as a common, you are going to detail about all these three topics in your unit of this facial pain. Okay, then you have diagnosis and treatment of pathology, cyst tumors, and head and neck oncology. All the tumors, all the cysts, all the pathologies are treated with the help of oral maxillofacial surgery. Then we do biopsies also, and we have many types of biopsies. Biopsy is surgical removal of oral tissue for the purpose of histological evaluation. So we have exfoliative cytology, FNAC, incisional biopsy, excisional biopsy, punch biopsy, frozen section biopsy, and much more. So which we consider into investigation section, right? Then we have periradicular surgeries like endodontic surgeries. Endodontic surgeries, we have episectomy as the major surgical procedure to remove all the pathological periapical tissue. So you remove this, first you give incision, then you reflect the flap, then you do the osteotomy, right? You drill the window over the apex of the teeth, and then you remove your root. Resection is done, you resect the root, and then you remove all of the periapical tissues, pathologic periapical tissues. Then you curate it, irrigate it, then you give the retrograde filling material, then you pack the wound, and then you close the wound. After that, we have cosmetic surgery, which is limited to the head and neck. So cosmetic surgery like retinectomy, which is facelift, brow lift, also known as blepharoplasty, otoplasty, rhinoplasty, septoplasty, cheek augmentation, chin augmentation like genioplasty, neck liposuction or lip enhancements, injectable cosmetic treatments like Botox or chemical peel, right? So these are all the vast scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery, and basically this is the syllabus of oral and maxillofacial surgery, which you are gonna read in detail about all of these topics. Then we have an undergraduate trained in the OS is expected to deal with simple exodontia, complications arising from the exodontia, right? Routine extraction complications like tooth root fracture, tissue lacerations, post extraction bleeding, minor post extraction infections. This should be dealt with undergraduate trained in the OS. Then we have immediate management of medical emergencies. How to manage the medical emergencies should be known by a UG student also. Then we have minor surgical procedures like episectomy, alveoloplasty. Coming to a PG student is basically a full-fledged oral and maxillofacial surgeon who are able to handle all the pathologies of face and jaw bones, and he should handle outpatient in the department as well as in the ward. Now coming to newer advances in OMFS. So in OMFS is basically constantly evolving and adapting newer techniques, right, to refine the surgical procedures and to achieve the precision with minimal invasive techniques. One such technique, if I tell you, is distraction osteogenesis, in which we elongate the bone, we will grow the bone with the callus distraction, gradual callus distraction. We do not use any bone graft material, but we are getting a new bone, a more bone, which is your bone deposition without any bone grafting. So that can be told as a minimally invasive technique. Then we have extremely the scope of oral maxillofacial surgery is extremely difficult to tell, Because of introduction of newer research based technologies and techniques, that's why students are advised to keep themselves updated with the new literature on the subject. Now, as an exam point of view, this topic is not important, but if you see two things, which is definition of OMFS, you must know, and you must know the scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery as a point of view from your exam practical viva voice. In viva voice, you are asked to tell about the scopes of OMFS, and examiner can ask you about define oral and maxillofacial surgery. So that's it with today's lecture. I hope this will be beneficial to you, and thank you all.